All right. As I always do, say, let's just get started, because I'm ready to get started. And it's the 18th of March. This is the day I had to be ready. And I'm ready. How about that? Started the morning off with just, wow. Yeah. Wow. Is the best way to express it. So I'm in the wow of this tremendous clarity this morning. Tremendous clarity. And then I said, okay, now I have to weigh myself. That'll tell the tale. Did I really discipline myself? Did I really go for it? See, that this is a way to sort of, for me, the weight reflects commitment and dedication, determination. Am I really disciplining myself? Do I really care enough? And I was, you know, four days ago, I was, you know, I said, wow, I may not make it. This is going to be very close to what happened. I made it. And I was under. In fact, I'm the lowest weight that I've been for, you know, ages, actually. I made it with room to spare. Holy cow. So I was willing to like almost fast yesterday to succeed at this. And I'm continuing on today. I was kind of like lost interest in food at this point. But and physically, I feel good. I feel good. So, and mentally, super, super. Great progress on the path right now. Wow. So everything is a go here. So let me just reassure everyone that it is possible to do this. It is possible to do this, you see. It just requires faith. Requires faith. You can call it confidence. I call it super confidence. My term for faith is super confidence. I'm super confident. Super positive, super confident. Now the intensity, the opportunity is tremendous, tremendous right now, if you're willing to be super confident. So again, this is, you know, by way of reassurance that I'm doing super great. Wow. I'm really, 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 really very wowish. So let that be like a beautiful warm sunshine to you. You know, wherever you are, just say, oh, the sun is still shining. For sure it is. For sure. The birds are all over the place here. And springtime, isn't it? I mean, spring's coming up very soon, 20th. So, more and more and more is being revealed to me. So we're about to hit a bump in the road, okay? It's a bump in the road, that's all. Spirit lost its nerve, 1973. Panicked. And we're going to reap the whirlwind of its panic. The world is going to feel that bump in the road because spirit panicked, because it didn't understand familiarity. It's not familiar with familiarity. It's very difficult for spirit to relate in any way to this issue of familiarity, which is a sort of feels like an alien issue to it. Freedom. It's the price we end up having to pay for trying to structure mind is familiarity. So we must be repentant. Spirit must be repentant, realizing that it does have to pay this price to overcome this familiarity bias. I'm gonna hit my smoothie here. I'm gonna without recognizing the familiarity bias, continuity fear that it has, it runs into panic. It makes progress. It's shocked by the progress, and then it panics. So that's what happened here in the world, this world. So I'm getting an overview of the whole of the world and the future and spirit and what can be done and all of that. I'm getting more and more clear about all this. So taking the big picture, we can calm down. I say, okay, so spirit has panicked. And it's been the last 44 years. It's been in a state of panic, frantically trying some other solution. It says, oh my gosh. Spirit did make a lot of progress. Okay? It has made a lot of progress. So nobody needs to despair about spirit. We'll be fine. Spirit will be fine. We are spirit. We'll be fine. We will be liberated from our familiarity bias against certainty. But in the short term, it's going to be a bumpy road. We're going to hit a real bumpy stretch. But that's just a short term. Later on, the Dharma will flourish for spirit as it starts working on the familiarity problem and recognizing this. So what I'm doing is I'm seeding, I'm putting all these seeds here in for spirit to reassure spirit. And this will help spirit get through this bumpy time in a much better way, because it realizes, oh, there really is something I can work on. I don't really need to prolong this panic. I can start backing away from the panic. But spirit needed this to happen here, so to help with the panic. It can't just be something abstract, and it wanted some help here in this world to live through these times and then still say, no, it's just a familiarity problem. That's all it is. You're panicking. And then to see that, and then spirit will say, oh, okay, that trust in that. That spirit was willing to go through this, in my case, to go through this, and then and see it. And so now there's a reassurance. Later on, it will be very, very reassured by this. And say, okay, for sure, that was just panic. That's all that it was. And my problem is familiarity. Our spiritual problem is one of familiarity, bias. We're used to doubt, trying to doubt, and so we're biased against certainty, just through familiarity, not through any reason whatsoever, but just through familiarity. That's it. There's nothing more than that. So spirit's fine. There's nothing wrong with spirit at all. It's just this familiarity problem has accrued, because we've tried so extremely to hallucinate the absence of God, and to cast doubt really upon God, the reality, cast doubt upon reality, that we've believed in our own marketing scheme. That's the cardinal sin, right? To believe in your own marketing scheme when you're trying, it's a scheme. And that's why some of these rock idols and pop idols and stuff, they don't let their children get into any of that stuff at all, because they know it's a scheme, it's a scam, and they don't want their children to fall for it. That shows something, doesn't it? That they know what they're doing is not dharmic at all. And so they don't want their children to be exposed to what their own career and what they're doing. So there's nothing wrong with the mind at all. There's nothing wrong with the mind. So bias is just the jitters kind of thing. It doesn't mean that there's some functionality problem with the mind at all. Not at all. So this has to be brought up And this has to be the approach going forward. So spirit, in order to back away from panic, spirit has to know there's some approach to deal with the shock of success, of setting down hallucination. It has to know that. So what the Dharma Kings have been working on, and I'm part of that, is to go towards this full stop in the wow practice. As the only equation there is, there's nothing to equate reality with. And we keep trying to equate truth and lies, trying to equate lies with truth. It's like trying to equate nothing with everything. There's no equation at all. But we're so used to trying to equate equations. Science is all about equations. Materiality is all equations. This you can equate with this. There's nothing to equate with reality. Reality is all pervasive. What could there be to equate with it? There's nothing at all to equate with it. So we have to back away from equations, from trying to equate anything with truth. Just truth is true. That's all there is to it. Truth is true. That's the equation. Truth is true. But so what we use is wow as the equation, the final equation. All equations, we back away, but we still keep wow. Truth is wow. We equate truth with wow. And this helps us back away from all attempts to equate anything at all. So, what we're doing here, excuse me, is reassuring spirit. And so it can, like a bridge to get through this bumpy time, so that it can go into a much better time to get down to business, get down to the dharmic business of practice. See, spirit isn't practicing yet. It's backed away from that. It panicked. It was willing to let the certain amount of structuring, trying to structure the mind, go. But in doing that, in doing so, then it panicked and said, well, wait a minute, I can't stop structuring. I gave up some, but so that it's trying to strengthen the remaining dream of structuring the mind. It's trying to intensify that. So it gave up some efforts, but then the efforts that still remain, it's trying to intensify those efforts. And that's the panic, that instead of saying, hey, let's just back away from all of it. We don't need, you know. It didn't do that. It's like saying, okay, you don't need to be sick, and you don't need to be sick, but those over there, I want them to stay sick, and now I need them to be really, really sick. Okay, so this is what spirit's doing. So the minds that are not, the aspects of spirit that are not going to be dharmic and released, now spirit is demanding that they be really, really confused, fearful, biased. You know, I say biased. Okay, very, very biased, and work really, really hard on trying to structure the mind and defend against setting down hallucination. So this is the situation that we have in the world right now. The panic started in 73. It's been 44 years of trying to bring that forcefulness into the remaining champions of structuring, trying to structure the mind. So it's kind of, so spirit's in this, you know, delicate situation, and it's saying, huh, you know, what if this doesn't work out? And it's obviously, it knows that you know, it's not going to really work out, is it? But it doesn't know what else to do. So we can greatly shorten the troubles and lessen the intensity of them by sowing the seeds here of this teaching, full stop on the wow, apex wow yoga. It's a practice. And we just practice just sitting with this one equation. Wow. And what are we doing? We're equating wow with reality. That's it. We're just equating wow with reality. Now, wow is a very, very abstract term, very abstract. But it still has a faint feel of equation, doesn't it? So we still feel we're familiar. At least we're paying homage to all our efforts to equate something with reality. But we're letting all of the other efforts die down, and just the wow, just the wow. Ramana would say, just the I, just the I, trying to equate, just I equating with reality, nothing else. But we're using the wow, and Ramana gave me permission to do this. He says, that will work really great. He says, that's really going to be very, very effective. He prophesied to me. He said, what you're doing is going to be extremely effective. It's going to be very helpful for many. So keep doing it. So I said, okay, because I said it's a little different. It's wow instead of I. He said, da-da-da, that's fine. That's fine. It's going to be very, very helpful. It's we're in a more scientific age, so we can relate to this idea of equations. So wow is like an equation, like we're equating wow with reality instead of trying to have like I identity. I don't really get into the whole self identity, things like that. It's more because I have a scientific mind, actually. I mean, we're in a scientific age, and so I have used a scientific mind on the spiritual path to clarify everything, actually. True scientific mind is a good thing. It's very reasonable and honest. The whole idea of science is to be honest and go where the facts lead you. Okay. See what the facts are, and then you must accept what the facts dictate to you and show you, right? That's a scientific mind. It's all about honesty. So I love science. I love the practice the Western world has gotten in science, because it's all about honesty. Now, unfortunately, science has collapsed. Now it's all about greed. But before it was the aristocratic, gentlemanly, bourgeois sort of thing of let's be scientific. In other words, let's be honest. What's really going on? What do the facts really tell us? Instead of trying to impose, you know, greed upon everything, or impose our own neuroses or fear upon reality. What are the true facts of reality? And then, you know, you do hypotheses, you do experiments, this and this, and then you develop theories, and then you test the theories out. So I'm extremely scientific. I'm a great scientist, actually, because I have that honesty of that. And so this is what is been so helpful for me, is to do it that way. Honesty. What really works? What is the evidence, historic evidence suggests? Okay. And then you come across, of course, the grace of God, the faith, the saints, all of that. And then you say, well, these are facts. Let me see, where do the facts lead me? That's science. Science doesn't have a preconceived notion of, you know, that the facts have to prove what our preconceived notion is. They say, what are the facts? And then we have to accept the mandate of the facts. Then there's so much empirical evidence of the grace of God. You know, to ignore that is to be completely dishonest and therefore totally non-scientific. So I'm a fruit of the scientific age. And some say the ancient rishis were extremely scientific. I believe they certainly were. Just like the Tibetans, very scientific. Tremendously scientific minds. I mean, they're so honest and so aware of the facts. They don't ignore the facts. We have the capability to ignore facts. The true facts, really. Like, theoretically, can we equate nothing with something, with everything, for instance? No, you can't have an equation with nothing. Yeah, that's totally non-scientific to say such a that's absurdity. So science rejects absurdity. Unfortunately, they've gone just halfway. They lost spirit, lost its nerve, because science was being too effective. Like, oh my gosh, You know, we have to accept, you know, the facts. And Spirit said, oh, okay, I'll allow the facts, some to accept the facts, but the others, no, they have to really reject them. So we're in a time now of rejecting true science and putting pseudoscience in its place. The pseudoscience of materialism. That's just a pseudoscience. Pseudoscience too. Pseudoscience. And it's dishonest. Very, very dishonest. Hello, screen. I went to screensaver mode and it's just, I don't know. An error is preventing the slide. Okay. Go back. Ah, this computer, you know, you never know. At any moment, it'll just do come out of the blue. So it's the right now. Spirit has decided to go back into you know a lot of dishonesty, and cover it up. Of course. So we're in that, and now the calendar suddenly popped up. The calendar has never popped up on my screen before, and the calendar suddenly popped up. I didn't even know I had a calendar. So it says it's the 18th. Thank you. Okay, well, this is pretty interesting, because I brought a calendar out with me for this taping for the first time, I think, or maybe the second time. I don't know. So that is amazing how a calendar pops up on my screen. So extraordinary, isn't it? So September 23rd, I've been talking about that. So there's a bump in the road is coming. There's no question. People are disturbed right now. Why? Psychologically, spiritually, we know it's going to get bumpy, bumpy road. Spirit is panicking, and it's and it's trying to reinvest in trying to fixate the mind, but it knows that some of us are not going to do that, and it's accepted that, it's okay with that, but it's then trying to use the other ones to really severely reinvest. And basically, the way that this dream trying to fixate the mind works is what we call through nature. Imagine nature, it's a dream. And that which structures nature is called the feminine, gives birth to more form, gives birth to structure. And then the males are supposed to help protect that structure and provide and protect that structure. So that's how it works. But so this dream of structure, the feminine is the indispensable part of the dream. It's all a dream of spirit in terms of giving, replicating structure and increasing structure. The men are you know, secondary in terms of they can, you can have a few strong men protecting a lot of women, sort of thing. So when spirit starts backing away from trying to structure the mind, structure freedom, actually structure perfect freedom, it's willing to it's willing to back away from the male aspect first. It says, well, okay, I don't really need that so much. It's not that important. So it's okay, I'll back away from that. But I don't want to back away from the feminine part of the dream yet, because that's really indispensable. So when it backs away and says, okay, men, you can be free. That's okay. I'll set down the male aspect of the dream. But then it starts saying, but okay, now can I set down the female aspect of the dream? And that's when spirit gets the jitters. It says, if I do that, that's the end of the dream. I mean, there won't be any more structure, really. No more replication of bodies, right? And then, so this is where spirit gets really nervous and jittery. So that's what happened in this world. And spirit said, "No, I'm not quite ready to back away from the feminine aspect of the dream. So I've got to strengthen that aspect and keep that aspect and make it really strong and invest all of the intensity of this effort in the feminine, which gave rise to feminism. That's why feminism arose, and this decision was made in 1973." To decide to not back away from the female aspect of the dream, and instead to strengthen it and invest all intensity in the feminine, and including the intensity the males used to have. So this is why the masculinization of women, just feminism, started in 73 really, really strongly. That was the decision that Spirit made. So you can see that, that from that standpoint, right, from then, 44 years later, how the feminine, that Spirit insisted the feminine now acquire all these male traits. So both feminine and male traits are invested in the female aspect of the dream, which is why women, the female aspect is, you know, anything that men do, we can do too. And they insist, you know, that, you know, martial arts, fighting, you know, dangerous sports, vicious sports. And the goal really, Spirit is trying like I said, bring those traits that men are in, especially violence. They're trying to make women really violent, extremely violent. They want violence to be expressed. Spirit wants violence to be expressed through women, through the feminine, because it's realizing it's letting go of the masculine in part of the dream. So it wants to invest the traits that were expressed through males of fighting and all this kind of stuff. It wants them to be in the feminine part now. And some, and a lot of men are coming, you know, very gentle and very peaceful now, like myself, not violent at all, because we're waking up from the dream. We're no longer going to be, we're going to be dharmic and bodhisattvic and be Buddha mind and help out later on, help Spirit back away from the entire dream, all of it, set it all down. So as the male, the Spirit backs away from the masculine part of the dream, it then invests the forceful violentness in the feminine. And so that's been feminism. And I see the women jogging down the road, and their shoulders and their build is extremely masculine. And the vibe you get from them is very violent, very violent. A lot of females now, just easy for if you're sensitive to tell what's their vibe. And it's very masculine, very forceful, and very violent, actually. And they're in the military. I mean, they're demanding combat roles. All this stuff was totally unthinkable prior to 73. Okay, totally unthinkable. There is no way in the world, organize, boxing, fist fighting, everything, knocking each other out in violent encounters. This is what the women are into. So many are into very violent kind of stuff, very dangerous, violent stuff. And the way they talk is violent type of talk. I was shown by this by a woman yesterday. It was really quite extraordinary, very frightening. Very frightening. I mean, she was total gangster, you know. I mean, violent. And the women actually now are more violent than the men in a lot of ways. This is because Spirit decided to invest this violence, which is a forcefulness of trying to fixate the mind through death and violence and attack. It's now investing that in the feminine aspect of the dream. So this is the bump in the road that we're about to hit. Okay. So we're wise to all of this, and I was fortunately tipped off by this by Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma yesterday. And of course I've been tipped off by this continuously for the last 44 years. I was aware of this. I say, wow, this is, if we, Spirit, you need to back away from this. This is, you're going to make a very bumpy road. And Spirit says, I can't, I'm panicked. So then I had to then find a way to help out with this. Had to up my game. Over the last 44 years, I've had to up my game to an extreme extent to help out with this. Yeah, I'm more scared of women than men in terms of violence these days, for sure, for sure. They have a violent attitude, actually. And that this old woman, this wise old woman, a couple days ago, told me something. I can tell you what she said. She said, I've raised 5 kids. I raised 3 girls and 2 boys. And let me tell you something. The boys were beautiful. No problem at all. They get in a fight, and as men do, and then I'd say, "Boy, shake hands. You're gonna be best friends for life," and put it behind you, and they shake hands. And she said, "That was it. It was gone." She said, "The women, hell. I mean, they would grudges. They'd hold grudges against one another. They're vicious. It was so difficult to raise them," she said. I said, "Yeah, wow. This is coming from a, you know, someone with really experience, just conveying this to me." And so, when spirit panics, it's expressed through this hostile kind of violent, vicious type of mindset. And so, that was used to be expressed through the men, as women were structuring a spirit panic. This is okay. I can't spare the women this attitude. So, do all this stuff to deal with the fear, the insecurity of hallucination. But now that it backed away from men, realizing, wow, that's not right. This doesn't work. It's now saying, okay, women, you got to do that. So the attitude's like, okay, we'll do the fighting. If you don't want to fight, guys, we'll do the fighting. If you don't want to be vicious, we'll be vicious. We'll be overtly vicious. And that's what's happened. That's what's happened. Guys are going to say, let's just use reason, science, reason. Let's clear this up, and let's set down this idiotic, absurdist attempt, you know, to change reality, really. But that's spirit actually feeling this way. But then spirit then says, well, wait a minute, I don't know, I feel something isn't quite right. I'm scared, so I don't want to put it all down. So let me again. Put all of the effort into the feminine now. I'll put all the effort of the dream of the feminine and see if I can hang on to it that way. It doesn't have anywhere else to turn. It's not like it's saying this is going to work. When you panic, you just say, I don't see anything else to do but this. So you're hoping, so spirit's in hope and fear, hoping that it'll work. Of course it won't work. But we're certainly not going to go back towards investing it in men. Spirit certainly realizes that doesn't work. It doesn't really work. It's lost interest in that. It's lost interest in it, which is great. You see, it's great. So spirit has made a lot of advancement. So it's really stuck right now, bumpy road. Spirit's saying, should I go back to investing violence in men, or should I invest violence with women? It's panic. Say, no, drop the dream of trying to fixate mind. Of course, violence is just an attempt to produce evidence of fixation. A dead body, we believe, is a fixated body, which we equate the mind with the body, then we think the mind is fixated. It's completely absurd. It's completely absurd. This dream of nature is completely absurd. So down the road, I'll be, you know, working for in a bodhisattvic way for the Dharma. And right now, I'm just, you know, preparing for that. And you have to see things in the long term and see, you know, and have compassion for spirit. We're spirit. We're not any patterned after anything in a dream. We're the dreamers. We're spirit. So it's really compassion for spirit. Spirit having compassion for spirit. So it's very difficult for to be in the world, because, you know, I didn't grow up with women being vicious and violent in that way. They were covertly passive-aggressive, to say the least. But not this way at all. They expected you to do the fighting for them. And then when we backed away from that, said, no, we're finished with that. That's when now they said, okay, well, we'll do the fighting then for ourselves. They don't like Trump because Trump is a masculine type of guy who says, I'll do the fighting. And the spirit of the times is spirits, you know, saying, no, you know, we're going to have the women do the violence and the fighting, which is why they wanted a woman president in the United States. So the violence and the fighting could be expressed through the feminine instead of the masculine, because hoping that will work and fixate the mind that way. The spirit realizes the males cannot fixate, the male aspect of the dream can't fixate the mind. It's given up. It's like that. It says, wow, you know, that doesn't work. So what it has to do is realize that the female aspect doesn't work either. So that's the next, you know, push that spirit has to make, has to realize that. But first it's going to, you know, go through a bumpy phase, to say the least. I mean, the Facebook requests I'm getting now for friends are just crazy. You cannot believe the violent nature of these people and that request. And they're so messed up, spiritually messed up. But this is just showing me what the spirit of the times is. I say, why am I getting requests from these people? I get a request and the guy's banner, the banner of his Facebook page is a gun pointing at someone's head, you know? That's what I got this morning. It's like, and that's what I was shown yesterday by this woman. Extremely violent gestures. She the gesture she was making, that what she was yelling to people, just anybody, randomly. Like she's just saying, I want to just shoot everybody randomly. You know, it's like really violent. It scared me so bad. I took a side road. I said, man, I don't want to be following these people. You know, the gangbangers. But it was a woman that was the gangbanger. Okay, that's what it was. See, men are losing interest in this. It's not just it's spirit that's losing interest in it. So, as spirit loses interest in the dream, first it loses interest in men trying to fixate the mind, the male aspect. And that's what's happening. But it holds on to the feminine, saying, no, I'm not quite ready to let that go. So then the viciousness surfaces in the feminine, in the world, which is what's happening. And I know a lot of people, like, from my generation, just, and older, are just shaking their heads, just saying, what in the heck is the world coming to? Well, now we know. Now we know. And we'll just have to, you know, sort this out as we go along. But this is part of seeing it is the first step of that, and just coming, accepting, and realize this is what's going on. And then it becomes much easier then to sort it out and see, okay, what do we need to do? Well, as Longchamp said, we need to go to the Wildwoods. Absolutely. Now, I'm trying to figure out this calendar, September 23rd, as we kind of shift gears here a little bit to help everyone relax. So March 18th, I take March 18th here. Okay, so let's start the weeks and count the weeks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It's not going to add up. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. Maybe I think it was from the beginning of the year or something that I counted 44. Let me see, January. Start with January to September 27th. Is that 44 weeks? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just bear with me. We're having fun here. We're talking about the September 23rd. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35. No, not quite. 36, 37, 38. So what was it? Did I miss it? Maybe I missed a month. Yeah, that's not, that wasn't it. There was something. But it was 144 weeks from the December 25th, 2015. And it's the days, if you count from the days and to starting, like, if we start the first day of spring, I had to be ready before the first day of spring. If we count from the first day of spring, which is the 20th, and you count the days, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, is it 144 days? 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. I can just count the months, just add it on. But I did the counting before, and it's right on the depending, if you start on the 20th, and it's right on the 23rd. If you start today, it's on the 21st, which is, I believe, Rosh Hashanah in September. So, yeah, Rosh Hashanah. So if you started on the 18th, you'd have 144 days to Rosh Hashanah, that's September 21st. But if you start on the first day of spring, 144 days is right on the 23rd, which is what's prophesied. But the prophecy could be off a day or two. I mean, it could be the 22nd, the first day of autumn, 21st, Rosh Hashanah, the Feast of Trumpets. So I was told at the 18th to be ready by then. And the Holy Spirit usually gives me a day or two of leeway like this, just to make sure that I'm ready ahead of time like this. So if we started counting on the 20th of March here, okay, this is the prophecy of the Virgin clothed in the sun with the moon at her feet and 12 stars at her head and in labor. That's an astrological prophecy that is fulfilled on the 23rd of September, 2017. First time in 7,000 years it's been fulfilled. And we're told that this is the time to where the tribulation will start. And if pre-trib rapture is true, then there may be some that shift at some way. There may be a shift, I don't know, what some sort of spiritual shift before the 23rd of September. And certainly the speed of everything right now indicates that this could be, there's no doubt that this is on track, okay, because the speed that I'm feeling right now is such that by the 23rd of September, we're going to be very far along indeed in our wisdom. And our nerves will have calmed down and sorted it out in a beautiful way. So, what was I going to do? I don't know. I'm just showing you the the calendar. Yeah, we are looking at a calendar. If you can't really see it because it's too bright. There you go. If you start the 20th, let's see. April has 30 days. May 31, that's 61, and then 30, 90, 91, and then July 31, 122, and then August, what am I doing? I'm doing too many, let me see, 30, 61, oh, I know what I was, okay, I'm supposed to count from, I counted from April 31st, that's 144 days. That's right, April 1st. So what? Earth Day, 22nd, April 30th. No, April 30th, I'm sorry. April 30th. Oh, interesting. Okay. Because April only has 30 days. Right. So that's pretty interesting. When I said April 31st, Jesus returned between April and May, at the end of April and beginning of May. So when I said April 31st, that really means on the night between the April 30th and May 1st. So if we start counting from the 1st of May then, let's do that. We have 31 and 30, 61 and 31, which is 92, and 31, which is 123. Okay, now we're into September. 123, we'll start counting. 24, 25, 26, 7, 8, 9, 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40. 1, 2, 3, 4. Rosh Hashanah, the 21st of September. So, it could be that a dimensional shift could happen on the 21st, okay, of September, and then the tribulation starts on the 23rd, something like that. Or this astrological sign is not exact, because Jupiter, you know, when do you say it actually exits a certain area? Well, it's exiting during this time of this week of the third full week of September, from the 17th through the 23rd, so to speak, or the 20th through the 23rd. This is like a 3-4 day time frame when Jupiter is exiting. So any time within this time frame, so there's basically what we're saying is there's a late September starting, let's say the 18th of September through the 30th of September, something like that. 13 days, something. That's Yom Kippur on the 30th. The latter part of September is when this prophecy in Revelation is fulfilled. So we don't need to hammer it on the 23rd, but it is true that that's 144 weeks from December 25th, 2015, the year that Jesus returned to the world, and 144 days from the day he returned, which was right between April and May, that evening between April 30th and May 1st, it lands exactly on the 21st September, Rosh Hashanah, 144 days from there. So you have this constellation of what's happening, and the way the world is going, and every sign that I'm getting indicates we are headed for that bump in the road. The spirit most certainly did panic, and hindsight is can be 2020. We have the hindsight now. I've lived through it, so I have the hindsight. I know what happened here. Spirit did panic and set a course and has stayed true to that course, trying to invest both male and female qualities in females, and especially this is coming out expressing viciousness, violent tendencies in women, in the feminine aspect of the dream. And basically said, look out, stand aside, boys. We'll do the fighting. We'll do the violence. We'll do the destruction. You know, we will structure the mind, and we know how to use violence to do so. And so that's what's going on. I'm watching these female surfers, you know, and they're doing violence to the waves. You know, they're not as powerful as the men, but I was watching. I said, my gosh, you know, they're ripping the waves, and the way different men surf differently. Some of them surf a beautiful way, and others surf in a violent way. There's different styles of surfing. There's one of just being at one with the ocean and one with the wave, and the beautiful, like Jerry Lopez or something, a beautiful style is you express the peace, the Tao of surfing, so to speak. And that's what I like to see. Give what the wave offers you. You know, and be in harmony with the wave, the Tao of surfing. But the other styles out there is the rippers and the carvers who are there to smash the wave and destroy the wave. They use the power of the wave then to carve it and to go off the lip. They're trying to destroy the lip of the whole top of the wave off. And the judges, you know, reward that for that kind of thing. It depends on the judges, really. So surfing is very subjective. It depends on what you're looking for. If you're looking for the art and the beauty of surfing wave, you would judge it very differently. You would see the smoothness of being in harmony and the flowing with the wave, giving what the wave offers you. If you're making turns, the beauty of the spray kind of thing, the beauty of the spray and the beauty of the arcs and the beauty of the lines that you're taking and all this kind of stuff. The art of surfing, the Tao of surfing, would be more highly rewarded rather than tearing the wave apart. But you see a lot of these surfers are there to just do violence to the wave kind of thing. And you see these women, you think they'd be more into the art. Some of them are. They're like longboarders, and they're just like the beauty of being at, you know, just giving what the wave offers you and expressing in a graceful way as you're riding on the longboard. But the others now, they're very vicious and violent the way they surf the wave. And that just shows you what a massive change in culture has happened. You would never see that in the past. The women that used to surf, they longboarded, and they would do gymnastics with men on the wave, and they would do poses, on beautiful poses, as they're riding the longboard in the ocean, you know, to express, you know, the gracefulness of the water and the ocean and things like that. They wouldn't think of trying to destroy the wave. So it shows up in the surfing. It shows up what has happened. I'm just like, look at this. I've never watched women surfing before, really. And it's just like, wow. And the women are very strong. I mean, they're in the gym constantly. Very masculine, a lot I'm looking. And you know, their attitude is bad. I'm just going to shred this wave. I'm just going to destroy it. I'm just going to shred it. Like, holy cow. So there you go. I mean, it's all over the world, all over the world. Women are the gangbangers now. That's how spirit is investing in its dream. That's the direction it's going in. Very much so. Taking drugs, so many drugs. I mean, they're doing so many things that were unthinkable for the feminine in my age growing up. Absolutely unthinkable. But then it started, the whole thing started with feminism, and in 73 it tipped, and women started becoming very crass and crude and belligerent and bullyish and violent. And, you know, the thing is it gets worse. When women are like that, it's worse for society, because men, like this old grandmother told me, she says, look, the boys would be aggressive and fighting and stuff, and then she'd say, boys, that's enough. And then they stop, shake hands, and they shook hands, and that was it. And they didn't hold any grudges. She said, they didn't hold any grudges at all. They're able to just let it go. Whereas the women, she said, they can't let it go. They were incapable of letting it go. So when women are, when in spirit tries to invest this aspect in of trying to fixate the mind, you get a steady situation in the world. You get, you see, everything collapses into anarchy, actually, and the movement of anarchy is global, worldwide, really brought is anarchy, which is why they hate Trump. Feminists hate Trump because he's insisting on order again. No. You know, let's go back to the way it was. That's no. The we have to, you know, they have all these grudges. They can't let it go. They can't move forward. They stall out. This is a very vicious thing that's going on. Strut, but just the traditional, look, we'll handle the fighting. And when it's handled, it's handled. And then we move on. And you know, back to business, no grudge. And that's how it works. But the feminine spirit manifesting in this dream, is no. You know, I trust that we'll hold on to the dream, the feminine aspect, onto the feminine the dream through the feminine aspect. And I want them to have this, you know, hostility, fighting kind of do it. I want them to do all of it. So that's right now going on. That's why there's so much hatred for Trump. From the feminists, hate him. They wanted, you know, Hillary, women to be president, so that they then give a carte blanche to this. They're very aggressive, really. The aggression, you know, the aggression they have now is, again, the female dream is being invested with this aggression, which is to defend the defenses of the indefensible. Absence of God it's totally unstable, and we feel totally insecure, because it is. The mind could drop the hallucination. It'll always be that way. But when we try to fixate it, we feel very sure. And so the way it's been structured, the dream, is for that the feminine feel about trying to, you know, structure them. I think all this way is going to work. And so the insecurity has to be projected onto something else. So it's projected out there to that style as evil. And the feminine says to the male aspect, be aggressive towards that style over there, because that's where my insecurity, the dream, is coming from. So go destroy that. Sent like drones to, you know, be weapons, destroy that aspect. But But spirit has realized that. It's losing interest in that. Through all the spirits come into this to spirit. Spirit's waking up from the dream. So first it lets go. That's the first thing it will do. But it won't let go of a virgin altogether. It reinvests it in females. So 73 was the decision in investing aggression in females. Overt being the button pusher, saying, guys, I'm threatened by that, so go destroy it. They're saying, I feel threatened by that, I will. Okay, so that's what it's really about. It's spirit taking tactic to try to hold on to this dream of absurdity. And yet, spirit also, a very good sign, said, you know what? This might, you know, that I don't feel secure about this, actually. And I'm not sure what to do. That's why Trump was elected, actually. The spirit's saying, I don't, it doesn't look like it's going to work well, investing all the money. So, a spirit ambivalence right now. As you would expect, spirit panicked, but it's been panicking for 44 years now at this minute. You know, maybe there's something better. Maybe there's, you know, maybe I can wake up. Maybe I can do that. So, from female aggression, saying let's just get down. Spiritual practice actually is the way to do it. So the way spirit backed female aggression was to have Trump come in to be the president. Whatever aggression is to be used, we'll have the men do it, and say, we'll say let's back away from this thing. It's a way for spirit to say let's go down this road too badly actually. So it's a pint from spirit actually. Very positive. If you look at it from the standpoint of do, saying, you know what? Maybe there's a way. Maybe there's a better way. We don't have to pull everything down into anarchy, which is what's been happening. You know, really, if we have kept going the way that we were going towards anarchy, violent anarchy, that's what happens. And yet spirit, oh yeah, that this is great, everything's fine. But in the back of the spirit saying, you know, I don't quite believe that everything's fine. And then it says, I'm a song of salvation, you know, that I like the song of salvation. I'm more interested in that. Maybe I need to just back away from this that I'm trying out. But I don't know where to go. So I go back to what I'm used to with more male aggression taking care of that. Let me take a breather and let me reconsider. So this we're in this iteration right now with Trump, is we're taking a break and say, wait, spirit is saying, maybe there's a better way. So we've kind of gotten this, been super helpful. I mean, if Trump had not run for the presidency, we would be in spiritually. The very fact that came into the seat, and not so fast here, girls, you know. We're not quite ready to transfer the show and pull us down into anarchy, which is what would happen. Everybody that spiritually attuned was given this great period to say, wait a minute, now let him to work on what the solution really is. So, you know, Trump is not the solution. But it's a grace period where we'll spiritually say, okay, what is the solution? Oh, repentance, accepting we can do that. And then, oh, equation, we can hold on to equations that set all the other ones down, then allow the peace of God to come. Wow, we could use this, wow. So there's this spiritual that is spirits. It's been seeing it and hearing it and being aware of it to have helped out a lot with this. As has Jesus, Sri Sri Nandamai Ma Ram Maharshi, the Dharma Kings, Lodur Longchenpa, Padmasambha, Manjushri, etc., have been pushing this right now. Where spirit, well, maybe there's a better way. Maybe there's a, I don't need to try and invest a feminine. Maybe I can back off the feminine too. Maybe there's a way. So that's why Trump was a. Is maybe there's a better way. Maybe I don't have to, at least I can shorten the time. Not shorten, not a living thing would survive on the face. See a way. Away from this panic. It was going to destroy the world, probably through, you know, war. And worse, actually, there's worse technology than that that could cause a pole shift. Was apparently destroyed through crystals and lasers, some sort of high technology kind of warfare. That warfare now in the world. So it's not atomic bombs that is still worrisome, but it's the high tech weaponry that we have now, the high tech weaponry which uses the atmosphere, the gravity, uses all these cosmic forces, and that causes extreme problems in the world. Destroying the atmosphere, which is, they say, the world will be destroyed by fighting cosmic radiation because we don't have an atmosphere, or we've destroyed the magnetosphere, okay, will be somehow destroyed. So the more aggression is invested in the feminine, the more tricky it gets. Whereas if aggression is invested in men, let's have a shoving match or a fist fight or something. And then once that's over, say, okay, hands and have a beer and it is, it's the end of it. And, like you talk to a man, that grudge you had, I said, what grudge? I had this thing, oh, that was over. That was over. It's finished, done with. I don't even give any more thought to it. So. It's a much less dangerous type of aggression than feminine aggression in the dream. It's a dream, of course, of spirit. But as spirit drops that, it starts getting to this more very sneaky, tricky type of aggression of these high-tech weapons that are utilizing cosmic forces that can be atmospheres and ruin the planet, actually. So, the Bible says if those days were not cut short, no living thing would survive on the face of the earth. So, what Trump simply is going back to the simple male aggression type of thing. You know, let's roll up our sleeves. If we want to fight, let's just to face and you know, and then when we're done with it, that's it. Let's not have this push-button hacking in and just, you know, destroying the whole virus and hacking and wiping out all this stuff. And this is very masculine type of stuff. It's beneath us. I mean, if I want to speak from the masculine, you know, all this high-tech stuff. If you got a problem with a guy, you know, if you got a problem, you know, just face-to-face, say, okay, what's the problem here? And very, very, very quickly and easily, actually. You apologize and say, okay, let's, you know, and he says, yeah, I was kind of wrong. And before you know it, your best buddies again. So this is way, way than all the trickiness we have now in the world. All the biological agents, all this kind of stuff. Now you say, well, the men invented the erection of the feminine aspect of the dream, actually. They said, we want this sneaky stuff. We want to be aggressive. We cannot about how directly we involve our bodies to keep producing children, to keep this thing. So we have sneaky. And we have to be able to attack our enemies without us being harmed. We don't want to put ourselves in harm. I mean, the way that men used to solve it in biblical time, the two tribes wanted to wipe each other out. And wait a minute, there's got to be a better way than this. And so what they would do is there's two, they send their warriors out to fight with one another. Okay, and they'd say, you know, the little thing. Each side select a champion. It selects a champion. In battle. And then whichever champ, either the other he kills the other or the other submits. Usually it's a battle to the death back in those days, but it's submission. I don't know. That would be even. But then the war's over and the other side accepts defeat. And then they're just incorporated in. And so they keep all the material, the infrastructure intact. You know, the whole thing, everything's intact, everything, yet now they're governed by the other tribe and they become part of the very, you know, step for spirit to take, right? Also expressed religiously, we have a champion raise up. Of course, this is the spirit's imaginary fixation, God of fixated mind, which doesn't exist. So how could there be a God of fixated mind? Imaginary. But it would say, okay, this one to death, fixation. This body has been brought to fixation through death. And this is the champion, as Jesus said, we have the winner. You know, we fixate spirit itself. This was God itself in the world, and we were able to fix God. Therefore, everyone else needs to be incorporated. Now, we have won to incorporate everybody else into our tribe. That's what they did, tried to. So, is it madness? But it's lesser madness, you might say. It's sort of walking, instead of the two tribes, everyone fighting and slaughtering one another and the destruction of both civilizations and stuff, they just, the champions battle it out, and then they keep everything intact. So that it's like, you know what? Maybe there's a better way. So it's spirit. I feel there's a better way, and it's indirectly coming back to what really works. It's been walking it back, walking the dream back, and now it's at a point where it says, "Huh, maybe we're at a point where we say maybe we could even further, you know, and we don't really need to go through anarchy and destruction phase here in the world." Is expressing those who believe that they can walk further, and we don't really need to go into this vicious global conflict world of massive destruction through technology weapons and stuff that was on tap for the New World Order. We don't need to do that. So this is Spirit saying, oh, it's grace. And I've definitely benefited from this tremendously. So, oh my gosh, this is a grace period we're having here. Spirit is saying, I'm not so sure that I really want to destroy this world. Death is an attempt to fixate the mind. It is a mega attempt to fixate. Death is nothing more than some absurd effort to fixate by claiming that a body, a form, is freedom. In a form, and then killing that form, and then saying, is gone. Whatever freedom there was is now, I proved, that can fixate freedom, because the body is no longer in the grave. Same thing with, this computer again is just doing, it's saying, okay, so all this activity, we call it life, the world, as bodies move about, and biosystems, ecosystems of the world, is expressing life or freedom. All that shows that it's all fixated, so we're able to further attempt to fixate freedom. It would be to destroy an entire planet. But Spirit is now to do that. Right? Maybe with like more a conventional war, like a conventional male war or something. So it's back, attempting to back away from the destruction of the planet at this point. People say, oh, you know, Trump's gonna destroy the world, destroy the planet. It's if we were likely going to destroy the world. He's much more likely to work it out in a more conventional, you know, a champion sort of way. Look, country, he'll talk with me, we'll have this fight, tussle, and I'm a winner, and then that's the way it's going to be. That's the male way. And it avoids then, talk with the Chinese leader, say, look, one-on-one, let's get in the room. Who's got the tougher thing? And then we'll, okay, that's it. They avoid the warfare that way. This is a dharmic way of viewing the thing from spirit. I'm looking at it from the standpoint of spirit, which I'm not doing right now at all. You know, they're floundering in this, just floundering. This grace period with Trump may not last. It may not last. But at least we've had it. At least we've had it. And I've already benefited an extent that I'm able to move on now from the... That's how effective it was. But make no mistake about it, spirit of destroying this world. It's just a spirit's dream. But it can bring all sorts of forces to bear to make thereby trying to provide evidence fixation of freedom. But it's all to no avail, completely to no avail, because spirit is free to have an entire world appear. Systems instantly present. Everything is creation, actually. There's no cause at all. It's all creation. But we can create, imply causation. Dream of causation is just a dream. There's no real causation taking place at all. It's all creation. Creates. God does not cause. God creates. This is being the idea in the mind of God. A creator also creates. It does not cause. There's no causation. There's creation. So is this world created? Everything is created. None of it's caused. But we can. So we're able to create a. But it's just a dream of causation. That's all it is. Creativity to imagine, to dream. But in no way does that mean that causation is real. No. So there may be nobody in the world that has this view, the way of view, look at it this way. But I believe if you, that this is surfacing, that it's there in their psyche. And they cannot express it, this clip, but it's there. It's there. It's there. But I said here, so the spirit wanted it to be expressed here. What's there, but is it really, can we some expression of it, So we're getting to wow is the final expression of it. Practice is being dharmic. If we don't practice, so it's the effort of all of us to, meaning for spirit of spirit, to back away from the stream, to walk it back to wow. Walk it back to wow. Walk it back away from it. A lot of that, well, I don't want to jump into that now. I keep the flow going here. Because I can go in any direction, so I got to be careful not to be... So, again, what's really going on is an attempt to limit the damage, limit the damage, limit, the spirit is saying, maybe I need to back away from this really dangerous game of trying to destroy by having aggression expressed through the feminine. And there's got to be a better way. That doesn't mean that spirit is going to dispense with trying to fix yet entirely, no. But it's wise enough now, I'd say, let me limit the delay, really. Collateral damage. Let's limit the delay. There is a way. And there is familiarity. This is the way. Familiarity. Wow. So its new wave is coming. All right. That stalled out. It stalled out. Wave of Buddhism, Christianity, the great traditions, okay. Islam, Buddhism, Hinduism, all the various things. Where, quite a few. New thought, all this wave of walking back from the awakening, really, spirit saying, okay, losing it, held out because it didn't quite go all the way. It said, I don't know if I really want to go all the way on this world device to, it's a pretty good, pretty clever, creative device I've got here. I don't know, let it go yet. So it stalled out where it could destroy the world, actually, saying, wait a minute, there, I see a new wave coming in. I see, oh, there's a beautiful wave. Well, maybe I want to catch that wave. It's like a surfer. And they've caught this wave, and there's no wave coming, and they just say, you know what? Let me just wipe out. Or let's say they're riding a wave, and it's suctioning in front. You know, just the whole wave is going to collapse on them, and they see that. And then, so they go up to the lip, and then and they turn, and they leave. And they see this gorgeous wave there forming, and they say, gosh, huh. And then they're thinking, should going right into that section and just wipe out in the white water and just get crushed? Should I kick out of the wave and paddle out and catch this other wave coming? So this is a beautiful metaphor. So we're right at this pier, surfer at the lip of the wave, and we've gone up to the top of the wave, and we're able to look back and say, wow, look at that wave coming in. Wow, I have that wave. Can I ride that wave? Do I deserve to ride such a beautiful? And the answer is yes, we do. And so, get out of the wave and paddle out, and we don't have to go through all this wipe out. Like mavericks have our jaws at Piahi, the, you know, north shore of Maui, to be out of our pipeline, north shore of Oahu. You don't have to be crushed by this wave that's going to collapse, the right wave's ready to collapse. You can kick out. Absolutely, we can. So it's a matter of spirit saying, you know what, is there some way to deal with the shock of how, yes, there is. Wow, full stop and to deal with it. Our full stop and I. Our japa, mantra, yoga, guru yoga, full stop, just repeat the name of God, repeat the name of divinity, whatever. You repeat that. That's the only formula there is. The wow is the only definition there is. It's the only reality. 360 degree, it incorporates practices, simply definition, reaction, action. Everything is just wow. Say, wow. Can I do it? Wow. Do I deserve it? Wow. And then you feel centered. And you don't, your evaluation is all just wow. I have the evaluation and it's wow. You feel comfortable and centered, and you don't panic. And when you don't panic, you start acting intelligently. And then you say, well, I better start paddling. If I'm going to catch this wave, I better start at least paddling out to it, towards it. So intelligent practice then starts happening. Okay, so we have this beautiful surfing the apocalypse analogy here. Scout. Of the wave that's happening. You kick out and you towards this beautiful wave that's coming in. Because this beautiful wave that you see coming in, you realize, this looks like I could ride this wave a really long, maybe forever. I mean, the way it's lining up is perfect. The shoulders, it's not going to section on me at all. I'm just going to be barreled forever in this wave. Look at it, a long time. I could be really bare section. It's glassy. It's beautiful. And you see, oh my gosh, this is the wave of my dream. So definitely I'll kick out of the one that I'm on right now. It's about the whole shoulder's going to collapse, break, and be head over heels and anarchy. I'm going to feel. So Trump's building the United States, plain and simple. Suicidal. I mean, they want anarchy, actually. If the situation is south of the border, going down Central America and into South America, that you would build a wall too. You would build it, have it built yesterday.